My dear friends, a very good morning to all of you. I am G. Tejaswini, lecturer in chemistry, Government Degree College, Nedavolu. Now I would like to share my views on the topic by importance of binary liquids. As you all of you know, binary liquid is the combination of two liquids, that is especially two solvents. Here I consider completely miscible solvents. There are other two types of also there, partially miscible and completely immiscible. Now I consider completely miscible. Completely miscible means one solvent is soluble in another solvent completely in all directions, in all proportions. For example, if you take water and methanol, there is no separation of layer between them. That is completely miscible. For example, if it is completely immiscible means, if you take example of water and oil, there is a separation layer between them. Now I consider only completely miscible liquids. Now we will see the applications and everything. Solvent plays a very important role in all reactions, because for extraction of a drug or any compound, for separation, for extraction, for preparation also, solvent plays very important role in all these fields. In all chemistry fields, solvent is necessary. Not only in chemistry fields, in our kitchen and for everything solvent is necessary. So rather than using a single solvent, if you use multiple solvents or mixed solvents, it gives more applications for us. So why this binary liquids are this much important? Because of their molecular interactions between them. These molecular interactions are determined by using excess thermodynamical parameters. These can be calculated by using simple properties like density, viscosity and ultrasonic velocity. Density, as you all of know, that mass by volume, it can be determined by conventional methods like specific gravity bottle, and also by nowadays we are using digital instruments also. Viscosity is the measure of resistance of flow. That means it resists the flow of the fluid. If viscosity is more, that liquid flows less freely. That is more viscous. For example, oil flows very slowly. If water flows very freely, that means it has less viscosity. Viscosity also determined by using Astral viscometer or some digital instruments are also there. Next one is ultrasonic velocity. Ultrasonic velocity, the velocity of ultrasound waves. This is also determined by using ultrasonic interferometer. Now we will see the applications. Why I have chosen this? Because rather than using a single solvent, if you use binary liquids, we have more applications in biological process, in chemistry, in all fields, in pharma industry, in another industry, in petroleum industry, petrochemical industry, in all fields, we have so many applications. In practical aspect, density calculations are used in chemical engineering industries for calculation or dimensions of boilers, condensers, store deposits, etc. Viscosity is also used for the transportation phenomena, for fluid transportation, for mass transfer. For all these purposes, we use viscosity. Ultrasonic velocity is used for material testing in chemical industry and also for underwater range process also. So binary liquids have this much applications because of their intermolecular interactions. This thermophysical data of binary liquids is useful for us for calculation, characterizing the structures, and to determine these calculations gives us ion-ion and solvent-solvent interactions also. So in mixed solvents, if we use chemical separation, heat transfer and mass transfer, all these are applications for binary liquids. Now we will see the very important application of mass transfer in petrochemical industry. In petrochemical industry, transportation of crude oil takes very important role, because transportation of crude oil, in industry we have to transport crude oil from one place to another. During transportation of crude oil, some wax will be formed. Due to this wax, it resists the flow of the crude oil. We have to make that crude oil to flow freely. For that, we have to add pore point depressants. What is this pore point? Pore point is the temperature below which the liquid cannot flow. For example, if pour point of a liquid is 30 degrees. Below 30 degrees, that liquid cannot flow. To make that flow, because sometimes we have to transport crude oil below that temperatures also. Even at low temperatures also, we have to carry some circumstances, we have to carry that one. So to decrease the pour point, we have to add pour point depressants. Pour point depressants are in general alkyl aromatics, that is a solvent, and oil is a solvent. So this is a best example for binary liquid. Using pour point depressants, these pour point depressants are decreases the pour point of that liquid, and it makes that liquid to crude oil to flow freely. This is oil flow. Now another important significance of these molecular interactions is used in pharma industry for delayed or fast release of drugs. For example, in slow release of drugs, we use sustained release drugs and controlled release drugs are for slow release of drugs. Mouth dissolving drugs and sublingual drugs are for fast release of drugs. These are also because of molecular interactions between the body fluid and excipients. So for all these binary liquids, applications are very important, and these are all due to molecular interactions between the two solvents. So we have to calculate these interactions by using all these thermodynamical parameters. These can be evolved by simple properties like density, viscosity, and ultrasonic velocity. So we have so much of applications for binary liquids. Now I can conclude by these have this much of applications. So I have chosen this. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.